I'm definitely not in Kansas. I think I'm in this guy's neck of the woods.
You are.
I am. Okay, to be honest, guys, in his videos, my direction and everything is just completely opposite from what I thought. Because I thought that was north, but instead, north is over here.
Now you're going to ruin it for everybody.
It ruined it for me. Like, I am, like, literally just distraught about this.
Like, when you wake up in a town and you're sleeping on a car ride, and then, like, you, the next morning, you, like, have no idea which direction you're going. Like, it's 180 degrees.
I thought I had them all figured out. Nope.
You're
not
wrong.
I was wrong. I was totally wrong. But anyways, we're here at Tony Fast Farm. And if you guys haven't checked out his channel, it's Fast Egg. Well, you look at his shirt, you know, something like that. Cool guy though. But we're both Montana farmers. We're actually basically neighbors, right?
Close. I mean, Montana standards.
Yeah, Montana standards. We're like 5.5 hours away or 5 hours away, depending on what it is. So yeah, we're neighbors. But he's got a pretty crazy operation and he runs a lot of red. Ooh. Shiny old paint. Apparently this is actually sold. This is like a 2004-ish Steiger 450. Oh man, it does feel a lot different. That is a tiny hood. We were talking about the differences between this 450 and it's a 580.
Soon to be probably 680.
Oh, but anyways, the hood on this thing is a lot smaller than that 580. It's pretty noticeable.
I should have taken the red seat out before I sold it. What was I thinking? Because that's got the cloth interior.
That you just weren't thinking.
I missed an opportunity.
It's okay. It's okay. Sweet though. Oh, that one's got the cloth interior.
Mm-hmm. That was like one of the only ones that got ordered that year without the luxury cab.
So it's kind of a rare one.
I guess.
Tony, what is that? What are those right there?
Dad paid like $200 for that.
Oh, okay.
That's I think you wanted the tiller and it came with a tractor.
That's a good deal, actually.
Yeah,
that's a really good deal. This guy's got some mini talents, and that explains, if you look over here, he's got a sweet brake. Like, sweet.
You want to play with my press?
Okay. I do.
So that's 10 gauge.
Like this?
Yep. And we're set to, should be about 90, what it's set for, so.
So I just push here?
Yep.
Just hold it down?
Yep.
Oh, I want one. Oh, that's sweet. I could have used this thing so many times. So what happens if I do it this way? Can I?
Sure.
we need a hammer. Never mind. He's got an arm.
That doesn't bend 90 because it's already.
I better go before I break something. 4520 right here is our only PTO tractor that we have right now to run a grain auger. Our 7140, if you remember earlier when we were running it, pulling the land roller, it stopped moving. So we had to put the butt on the land roller. That 7140 got taken to our dealer. They pulled it apart. They found out the clutch packs were actually not very good in it, kind of chewed up and gone. And they also found a gear inside there that needs to be replaced. The rest of the gears around them, they said, are looking good. For whatever reason, that one was just kind of wearing funny. So they're waiting on parts, which means we probably won't have that 7140 for harvest. We might have it for the end of harvest, but it's hard to say. So this 4520 is the only thing we have to run the grain auger. Issue with this 4520, a couple things. Hydraulics are really, really weak. They work, but lifting the auger up and down is very, very challenging. Two, it overheats. So hopefully in hot days, it doesn't start heating up a little bit. We'll just have to watch that. And three, the PTO engage linkage got bent and it is super hard to engage and disengage. So I gotta try to figure out why. So what I did, took the car washer, rinsed it all off inside there so I can access the cover. And I gotta crawl in there and figure out why is it sticking, why is it so hard, and get that taken care of. And then I'll just check fluids, make everything's good, take the tractor, hook it up to the grain auger, and make sure that that's all good. Check grease, get all squared away, and then start tackling other things. So let's get busy. This tractor was getting kind of hard to shift into park, probably because that ears broke off. Find out if it works. All right, let's see if we get this thing on there. Oh, we've been only battling that for like 15 years. Sure wants to go and park easy now. I don't know what was taking so long for me to do that, but got it done. Feeder house looks good. There's one bar that was bent, took it off, fixed it. But I would guess it's ready to put the header on. So let's put the header on, because I think that's the next step. And I am back. Had a good vacation. It was good. The money and time at the lake house is slowly paying off. Really starting to enjoy that place. It's a nice getaway when you've got this waiting for you when you get back. Out of sight, out of mind. So it's pretty pathetic crop this year. It's been droughting really hard. We're gonna have some really, really, really bad yields. And now that half the farm's been hailed out, it's gonna be tight. But as you can tell, it's getting close to being ready. That's spring wheat. Some of the first planting, and it's just judging from the green that's in the field, 2 weeks. 2 weeks we'll be in that. Our peas are just a couple days out, so we're gonna be going here real soon.
So, but it's dry. There's smoke in the air from some fires far western Montana or in some of the states on the other side of that. It's kind of hanging here. It's definitely dry. It's bad. We're really dry. We're abnormally dry. Well, we're out getting a little bit of a look at the crop this year, checking out our hail damage to see what we gotta have the adjuster look at and whatnot. And this is the corner of a new variety of yellow peas. We put a special certified seed down that we paid premium on to grow new seed for next year. This was gonna be the seed for the next couple of years. And this corner, we thought it was all gone. There's about 300 acres over here, and this corner actually isn't bad. There's peas on the ground. The pods opened up. That's the problem with peas is they, like that one, you can see, opened up. The hard rain probably hit it and caused it to shell out. That's definitely a problem with peas. But there's peas here that we can get into, so we'll be harvesting real soon. But on the other side of this field, it's leveled, so we'll go look at that in a second. All right, we just went down about a quarter mile, and you can see how the crop's laying sideways. It's about toast. It's gone. There's nothing in these heads. It's a couple right there. It may be a bush or two left. I mean, we can run the combine through and see what we think, but it's probably not even worth combining. So here we got some of the canola. This did get hailed. And there's not pods on the ground, and there's not canola on the ground. I mean, they're still filling the pods, but surprisingly, it looks pretty good for being hailed. I'm surprised. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what this yields. I mean, honestly, there's not a bad stand here. Some neighbor said we might make 20 on this, 20 bushels an acre, and if it did that, it'd be tickled pink.
Wow.
Interesting. That's well, that's good to know. Yeah, drove around the farm, a lot of acres. Some's 100%, some's not even worth combining, some's 50%, we'll have to run the combines through it. We'll see, but an interesting year for sure.
All right, I'm in the belly of the beast again. This is Big Brute's first tank that we have on the brood. Here's where the cracks happen. You can see how plastic welded this like crazy, as well as this one here, which that didn't even take. But it's still leaking, and I don't want it leaking. So I decided I'm gonna go against my gut feeling, try some Flex Seal. See if it holds. If it does, I'll be a believer. We guys will know. We'll finally know. Put it to the test. I've been very doubtful, but let's do it. Ooh, that stuff's sticky. Good stuff, actually.
There we go. Oh. Yeah, it's still hot in there. All right, here we go. Water is officially above the cracks and it's not leaking. I guess check one for the Flex Seal. Looks good so far. We'll find out. Put some time on it. Hopefully I don't have to be chasing any fires, but if I do, I hope that tank holds.
Hey guys, I'm heading to the parts store to get some parts for those combines. But until then, I got an announcement to make. We're going to the Farm Progress Show in Decatur, Illinois. It'll be the 31st through the 2nd of September. The Case IH booth, make sure you guys come stop by and say hello. Should be a great time. Haven't had the show in public since 2019, so this is going to be a big show. Lots happening there. I hear there's a chance of big machines being on the lot, so worth going to. Anyways, be there. Come say hi to us. And also, I may not be there just because I'm possibly going to be having a baby at the same time. So if that happens before, I might make it. If it happens after, I probably won't make it. But my dad, my brother will be there. We'll hopefully see you all there. So, go to the show, Decatur, Illinois, Farm Progress Show. Case IH booth, make sure you come by. All right, take care, God bless. We'll see you in the next one.